nice little tree I made there. Nice.
And now for your edification. I wanted to do this yesterday for you folks, this test, but it was too dark. You wouldn't have been able to see anything. December 18th, yesterday. Gonna run this bad boy on 6 cells. Gonna use that battery just for weight to balance it out. Well, today I'm back out here on the 19th and we're gonna see if this puppy works the way I set it up. Now, remember I built this tail. This tail is unavailable to the public in this fashion here. 800 size rotor blades. Times that by 5 and you'll have the millimeters. 700 size tail blades, HK3 5025, big giant motor, 50 millimeters wide, 440 kV. That's very slow, and then it's even slower because I'm only going to use this 1 6-cell pack. Because as you see, I cut the plug off of this one, so we're just going to have 6 cells. So everything's going to be moving slow. That's on the varial. The bottom half of the frame is varial. Varial landing gear. This is a GT 700 frame. Got all that in my other videos. Let's try this baby out. 800 millimeters times 5. Put that right there like that.
Go, people. Diamond rotor head. Thank you.
diamond rotor head. My tail concoction works. Got the sun coming out here. It's like 9 o'clock in the morning, December 19th. Too dark to try it yesterday. You wouldn't have been able to see nothing. Thanks for watching, folks. Peace out. Wow. December 14th, man. In the middle of the day, look how foggy it is. Customization in there to make it a fork blade. Everything's backwards. It's in the line tail case. Got the special guide clip on there. Got the metal wheel on the back. Got all the metal on it. I'm gonna change this to the aligned one with the black plastic and get it to lock in here. Got the metal on the bottom, metal down here, and tray two. Diamond rotor head with the Vario cap. 120 tooth main gear, 12 tooth pinion gear. Got the helical gearing. There's the helical action here. This is an align pinion gear brace, align motor mount, customized servo wheels that I cut. I got them in the 12 millimeter hole, not the outside one, the inside hole. These are aligns. Thrust bearing inside the main shaft bearings. And regular bearings inside. Thrust bearing in there, both of them. That's why it's really big like that. Got the third bearing in there. Support the main shaft extra. Align screws. I put all the line screws in it. And there we go. Steel swatch plate from Vario. This is a really good driver from Vario. Swatch plate driver / follower. Now I couldn't use the align ball links. They didn't work good. So I left the Vario ones in there because they tighten up better. So I had to get the Vario clips. I mean the Vario ball links. Got these rods from Vario. Vario rods, 5 of them. Got the lights. Light for the tail, floodlight for the front, screws, more screws, exhaust, foam to go around the boom, door handles. The rods are 2.5 millimeters, and the ball links are 2.5 millimeters. When plugging in this castle link, you have to unplug the power wire too that comes from the speed controller. I need at least 25 millimeters of this smooth surface. So in order to get that, instead of having a 30 millimeter screw, I'm gonna have to order a 50 millimeter screw, which would bring the smooth surface up to 25 millimeters. And then I'll just Dremel off the extra threads